brought to you by ExpressCare Health and Skin Center. Get in, get out, get better.
Hafe, and welcome back to Healthy Living to coincide with this month being Down Syndrome Awareness Month. Tonight we focus on what exactly is Down Syndrome and how it's the most commonly occurring chromosomal condition. Joining me now is ExpressCare's Dr. Jitka Lom. Hi, Doc.
Hi, good morning.
So for those of us who don't know, what exactly is Down Syndrome?
Well, what happens in Down Syndrome is that you have three chromosome number 21s in every cell of the body. Now, remember when the egg and the sperm get together, you get half your chromosomes from your mom and half from your dad, and there's 23 of each. So you should have 23 pairs. And what happens in Down syndrome is that the 21st chromosome ends up with an extra set. And we don't know exactly how that happens or why that happens. We know some risk factors for it, but when that happens, there's a whole series of genetic abnormalities that occur in the child.
Okay, so what are some symptoms that would, you know, key you to the fact that maybe your child has Down syndrome?
Yes, it's usually quite obvious almost right from birth. The child has a quite large tongue that sticks out of the mouth a little bit, hard to close the mouth entirely. The eyes are especially slanted. The neck is short and kind of chubby. The arms tend to be a little bit shorter than usual. The child tends to be quite floppy, and about half of children with Down syndrome will have a heart abnormality. So when the doctor listens to the heart sounds at birth, there's something wrong. There are so many abnormalities, even in the shape of the palms, the fingers being quite short and stubby. The skin of a Down syndrome person feels different. It feels doughy. It's soft and spongy rather than a more springy kind of skin. So there are many, many physical signs and symptoms, but the test that's done is a blood test where in the blood cells you can tell that there is an extra chromosome.
Okay, so I know that the blood test is one way to find out. But say you have a child who does have Down syndrome, or a parent who has Down syndrome, is it something that can be inherited?
Well, it can. If you have a family member with Down syndrome, then you're slightly at higher risk, because sometimes what happens is you don't just get an extra chromosome, but a part of the number 21 chromosome attaches to one of your other chromosomes. So when it just splits naturally, you end up with sort of 1.5 extra chromosomes, enough to make those Down syndrome manifestations occur. So yes, to answer your question, if you have Downs in the family, it's a little bit more likely that you could have that happen to you.
Okay, and so for a person or a child with Down syndrome, does that affect their life expectancy?
It does. In the old days, Down's children used to not survive very long, but these days, because of better medical care and ability to treat many of these heart conditions, thyroid conditions, they're more likely even to get certain cancers, digestive problems, so many different kinds of health problems come with Downs. But because the medical care is better now, they can survive into their mid-50s and even 60s and develop problems of old age, including dementia and Alzheimer's. So you see that there might be problems in early childhood and then all throughout their lives. You may know that there is a prenatal test, and this is one reason why women really, really should have good prenatal care, especially in the first trimester, where you can have a blood test done to screen for Down syndrome before your 12th week of pregnancy.
So if you do screen for Down syndrome and you find out that your child does have Down syndrome, are there special measures you should take during your pregnancy?
Well, yes, then you would be classified as a high-risk pregnancy. Some people, of course, would opt to terminate the pregnancy, but many will continue, believing that child is still a gift to them. And then they would have special high-level ultrasounds to check the child while it's still inside, because nowadays the ultrasound technology is amazing. You can see everything. So they could detect prenatally whether the child had a heart defect, whether it had any other abnormalities that could be treated right from birth. So yes, special care would be taken during that pregnancy.
All right. Thanks so much, Doc.
You're welcome.
When we return, we'll answer some of your viewer questions.